Hi everyone, welcome back to the DevOps Lab. This week I'm joined by Martina Heemstra to talk about Delivery Plans 2.0 with Azure Boards. It's amazing stuff. You don't want to miss this. Hey everyone, welcome back to the DevOps Lab. I'm Damian Brady, and this week I am joined by Martina Heemstra. Martina, thanks for joining us.
Happy to be here. Excited to be here.
Yeah, awesome. So we are going to be talking about Azure Boards. And so we usually talk a lot about CI/CD and delivering stuff into production and all that kind of stuff. But we don't as often talk about the planning stage. And that's a super important part of this whole DevOps story, correct?
It sure is. Planning is central to a lot of things. And you know, the great thing about boards is it integrates with everything in your DevOps pipelines and stuff. So delivery plans is a new feature that we've just GA'd, which is a part of boards and central to that planning. So we're really excited to show that part off today.
Yeah, that's great. So we actually internally, we use Azure Boards for everything. Even like planning this show is done on Azure Boards, and it's not necessarily related to, to a CI/CD pipeline or anything like that. So it's super versatile. And delivery plans kind of gives a few extra features that people have been asking for.
It sure does. Yeah, it's gives you that timeline view of a plan. So there was three main scenarios that customers were asking for. First one was that timeline view, that roadmap view of a plan. And then they also want to see what's the progress? How far have I gone? Am I going to hit the dates or not? So delivery plans gives that. And then, of course, the all-important dependency tracking. You need to know, what's going to be done first, what's going to be done second, where do I have problems in my plan? So those were the three main scenarios we were delivering for customers. And, of course, it has to work across teams and projects.
Yeah, okay, absolutely. So I think probably the easiest way to have a look at what this can deliver is maybe if you can show us what it looks like.
Oh, happy to do it. And again, excited to announce we've created this. So this is available for everyone now. So I'm going to just start here with the plans. So it's delivery plans as part of the board service here. So you'll see it under the left nav. It works very similar to the old plans, except there's no extension you have to download anymore. It's a native part of the product and you don't have to pay extra for it. It's all part of the board service, which is great. So you'll see this looks very similar. You add a new plan here. And the difference between the old one and new one is you can now add up to 15 backlogs. The old one, it was just 10. And again, I just want to show here, you can go across projects, across teams, and different backlogs, whatever you need to pull into that plan. So you can really have that timeline view of your roadmap. So I have one set up for us, so this will make it much more interesting. So what you're looking at here is an actual roadmap plan. So this is called the condensed view. So the cards on the plan can either be expanded or condensed, and I'll show you that in just a minute. But the cool thing here is, you can show whatever timeline you want. You can freeze the bars here to get in. You can zoom in and out to whatever level you want it at. So that's something that's really helps customers kind of get that view. And what we're seeing here is a roadmap of epics, and then you have multiple teams working on those epics. So these are their feature backlogs, and you see it in this all nice one condensed view of everything. So we're looking at here, epics needs to be done here in April. Another one's going to be way far out, but you can start seeing what it looks like and maybe reorganizing where because you need to go.
It seems like it's a great view for those project managers and product managers who might be used to their Gantt charts and a bit more of the almost like the waterfall planning stuff, but this still ties into the backlogs that the team's actually using, whether they're using Scrum or Agile methods and things, correct?
That's right. It doesn't matter which method you're using. And you'll see a lot of portfolio managers and even Scrum Masters will use this, but it's a lot of Scrum Man or portfolio managers, project managers. You're right, it has that kind of Gantt view of it, but that's what we call that timeline view, which customers have been wanting. So, yeah. So another thing you'll note on here is these little red icons. So this is what we call our dependency icon. And I'm going to show you in more detail how it all works. But the cool thing here is, again, within the delivery plans experience, you can quickly see, oh, maybe I've got a problem here with a dependency. And you'll see that right away. So your eye's drawn to it and you know what to look at. And this will go across anything that has a dependency issue, it'll show up. So, I should add too. So these delivery plans are based on iterations, and the new feature is start date and target date. So, when we're doing that quarterly level planning or semester level planning, whatever your cadence is, a lot of customers have come back to us saying, well, we just don't use iterations for Epics. We want to use the start date and target date. And so that's what you're able to use. And so this backlog of epics here, it's all based on the start date and the end date of the epic. So, and delivery plans works with both. So what you'll see here is down here at the bottom, we have a team that's working in a 2-week sprint and they work off of iterations. See, so, and they can continue working in it. And then we have some teams that have a mix, some work off of an iteration here. Here you've got one that's start date and end date. And the reason I can tell that is because they're working on a monthly iteration here. So
that's really handy. It means you're not disrupting the team just to fit in with your kind of rolled up delivery plan. You're just viewing what the team's start dates, target dates are.
Exactly. Teams can continue to be autonomous in how they want to work. They choose what works best for them, which is core at it being an agile team. So,
yeah, absolutely. So you're gonna show me something more about the dependencies as well.
Yeah. So one of the dependency tracking is one of the big features we have. So I said the red icons here. So if you click on this, it brings up what we call our dependency panel. And it's basically walking the tree of your predecessor and successor links. So you have to define those for all your work items. But once you have those defined, it walks that tree and lays out where you've got a problem. Anything with the red exclamation mark or red lettering shows you, oh, you got a problem here. And here we see a problem between this feature and this epic, and we probably need to resequence some of the work. So this is how you get the detail information on it. Now, if you want to see something really cool, you can also visualize the lines. So if you click on the bottom of the card, you can now visualize those dependency lines. How long have people been wanting that?
So, that's amazing, yeah. Yes.
And again, here it works across the teams and the backlogs, and you see the there's a problem with it. It'll come with the red X here. So you can see. Wow. Visually, exactly where it is.
That's an amazing view, actually. Yes, I've had a lot of people ask me for that kind of thing before.
Yeah, wow. Yeah, this is a big one. This is one of those key scenarios we delivered on for customers. And I'm sure there'll be more feedback that comes with it, but this is a great way to start visualizing it. And if you don't want to see the lines, you just click on the bottom of the card. So,
yep. Wow.
Pretty so cool.
Yeah, and the fact that this is cross-project as well is something that comes up a lot. You know, can I see the roll-up of all of the stuff that I've got going on? And those dependencies across projects is pretty great too.
Yeah, well, that was a key thing here. It was customers were saying it's got to be cross-team because I've got all these teams working on different epics and stuff, and it's cross-team. And gosh, we have in our org, we have multiple projects, so it has to work across that. That's what our enterprises, expect these days. So,
yeah, absolutely.
It's key for us. So, yeah, so that's kind of dependency tracking. The other key scenario we wanted to deliver on was giving that progress view. So if I go, again, you can toggle these. So I'm going to expand the cards here. And here you can start seeing, well, what's the progress? How far along am I? And here for this epic, you see it's child features. And then we have user stories linked to those features. But you can see the progress roll up. Does it by percentage and then the item count. And this works across, again, all of them.
Yep.
Here, wherever you have links, you can see, looks like we need to get busy on this project. There's a lot of zeros here. So.
Yep. So one of the things that's really shining for me is the fact that this is all just based on data that's there. It's not, you know, trying to force a like roll-up view onto the developers or to the, you know, the engineers doing the work. It's just showing this information in a kind of a really absorbable format, if that's even a word.
Yeah. No, you're absolutely right. So customers don't have to do anything extra. I mean, you pull together the plan, but to your point, it's all based on the work item data you have in Azure DevOps. So when you're holding your program increment planning, planning session, defining what those work items are, you're entering in all that information, and it's in Azure DevOps, and then that just gets pulled into delivery plans as you build your plan out. So it's pretty cool.
Yeah, very definitely something that the people have been asking me for. so what else should people know before we provide some links and things like that?
Yeah. So we have the progress view here. Wanted to show a couple of things with the settings. We've added styling. So, you know, customers who use our Kanban boards, this is very similar. We can, like, if I want to show architecture work here.
That's great. Yes, we use that a lot with our Kanban boards.
You do, and you can pull it on. Tags, whatever, you know, you pick whatever works right for you. And if this equals architecture, we'll just save this really quick. And again, you'll see, if we go in condensed view here, you can see the coloring. So these are all the work items that are associated with architecture type work in this example. So that's pretty handy there too. So yeah, and then the traditional filtering. So this should seem pretty common to boards users. We see this in our backlog and our Kanban board. So we've pulled that over into delivery plans as well. So the filtering works there too.
So. That's great. Definitely both things that I use a lot.
Definitely. So, yeah, I think that's pretty much the main features. So, I've shown you the three key scenarios here. You've got that timeline view. If you expand this, you can start seeing that you see the progress view of work items, and then the dependency tracking. You know, clicking on the bottom of that card gives you those really helpful lines, and clicking on the dependency panel gives you that detailed information you need.
That one in particular blows me away. I think people.
Pretty cool. The team worked really hard on that. We have an awesome engineering team. So.
I know enough HTML to know that sounds very, very hard too. So great work from them. Oh, that's
absolutely
awesome. This is definitely going to be super useful for a lot of teams and a lot of companies as well. And you mentioned that this is GA and it's not an addition, it's not an extension or anything like that. It's just part of the product.
That's right. It's just a native part of the product now. So you don't have to download an extension from the marketplace. That's the old plans was an extension, but the current, this new one, you don't have to. I'll add too that if you have plans that were built on that old extension, they will work in this new one. So
great.
The new delivery plans, which is native.
Yeah. Oh, awesome. Oh, look, thank you so much for showing us this. This is amazing, just addition to the product, and definitely something that people have been wanting.
Yes, for a long time.
Yes, yeah. Well, I really appreciate you showing us, and great work to the team on this one as well. And for everybody watching, thanks so much for tuning in, and we'll see you at the next DevOps Lab.
Thank you.